tonight is kind of going back over what the feedback was at the hearing and see what our next steps are. I know Bob has some opportunities, so then we would meet it right after you have the information that you can share, if there is any.
Correct, one way or the other.
One way or the other, we'll just have to know.
We'll have an idea as to if that piece of property is available to the town now or in the future, so.
And then something about someone, possibility of.
A developer that takes former municipal buildings and repurpose them, that he's gonna come in and take a look next week.
So we kind of have to have a plan about this too, you know.
Just give us an idea, you know, are they interested?
Yep.
And if they are, they're not, then at least we know.
Yeah, exactly. So does someone want to comment about, I know you weren't there, but.
Yeah, we had a family emergency, like, shoot, but.
That's all right. Sure.
So it isn't clear to me that Silver Street is off the table, right?
I don't think it's off the table 100%.
I don't think it should be either.
I think that that's one of the things I wanted to talk about tonight, because, yeah, I'll let you finish and then I'll.
Oh, just, I don't think that we got enough feedback to say, don't build there and don't build town hall. And we had some input, you know, some ideas and thoughts about it, but I don't think we have enough data that says we shouldn't continue to pursue that location. For both of us.
I agree. My thought was that when you make the project so large, it's never gonna pass.
Exactly.
Regardless of how many people say that they support you, and, you know, they're definitely going, it won't happen. If you're talking about buying land and, you know, or whatever, but buying land, $300,000-$400,000 for 5 acres, I don't know, I don't know land that well, but you're adding that onto the ticket price. If you're gonna have a three multi-comp, they were talking about having police, fire, and town administration, another million plus for a fire addition. I just, that.
It's not gonna help.
And our purpose was to get the police out of Sullivan. That is our number one purpose. In my opinion, that is our number one priority. With the fire, like, of course, do they need it? Not as bad as they need to get out of the Sullivan. I mean, that's my opinion. I do think, though, it makes sense to bring town administration there, because then you have this enormous building with 5 people, or less than 5 people. So I do believe that that makes sense to add that to the project, which was $800,000 additional for a second floor, so that brought it to almost two, right?
Which is.
Almost $2 million, close to that.
I feel like that's nothing to be done with this.
Yeah, but the efficiencies that a new building brings to this project is enormous.
You know, after hearing the work we had to do on the air conditioning units and all the other stuff, stay here, and that's not gonna change. It's just gonna, we're gonna have more and more of them. So to me, it makes sense to cut our losses with this building and put the town administration in the same building, you know, in one location. And, you know, ideally, I would love to see a big public safety complex, but you're right, the more we add on to it, it's just gonna be too big.
Big city problem.
Yeah.
So I think what they were, I think they were trying to say to us that you need to have enough land to do it. Maybe not build it all at the same time, but enough land to do it, because they're saying that Silver Street will only do the police and town administration. There's no room, and they're also saying what happens if Rollinsford all of a sudden spikes with new homes, new people, our police department will have to grow, will that be enough? Did you get that feeling? Is that what they were saying? Yeah. So, hey, no, you're okay. The biggest fear is the amount of land out there that could possibly, 10, 15 years from now, become available. And, but we have to start putting both, well, yeah, you know, because you're talking schools and all of that. But, you know, we shouldn't build some restrictions, but, you know, from the selectmen.
We can do moratoriums. Ellie does that, we can do moratoriums.
But I think that was, I think that's what's back of people's minds, is so much open land right now. And if that ever goes up for sale, then we would be in trouble. And we would need more police. But you would be taking part-times and making them full-time, and, because it's right, I mean, you would have more full-timers.
There's a possibility, yes.
Yeah, I mean, so you're not really changing headcount, you're just changing in more hours in a full-time person versus a part-time, I would assume, but that's just my assumption.
How are you sized now with the proposed building that you've looked at for future? What's your, do you have a max, how many officers you could put in there?
I designed for current staffing.
Okay.
How many officers spend, how much time do officers spend in the building now? Because I had heard that they really don't spend it much time.
Right, but the patrol officers don't. Most of my day, most lieutenants' day is spent within the building. The officers spend very little time in the station, harassing and looking for it. But unfortunately, I mean, you have to have the space available for them for when they do come. Even though their officers, their cruisers, primarily their office, you know, they still have a place to be able to file cabinets and hang their hat and do their paperwork back at the station and whatnot.
But you accounted for that with this, right, this project?
Oh, yeah.
So you have a spot in the office for every individual that you have on staff right now?
Of course.
Yeah, okay, so, I mean.
But if we grow and get investigated, then you're gonna have two or three detectives, and then you know, that's the space inside, so it grows.
So, you know, going forward, then maybe they take the top part of the building, and maybe we build a town administration building somewhere else that includes the library.
That's a possibility, if we put offices upstairs versus, yeah, that's a possibility.
I mean, if it ever came to that, but we kind of deal with it when it comes.
I think for the next, you know, looking out and maybe even 20 years, this plan that we have, I think, would suffice for the town now. And out 20 years, that's my guess, based on, you know, I've been here for 30 some odd years now.
I think there's a planning board report too that proposed that the town is expected to decline size.
It's what?
Planning board is a report out.
I don't know if it's a planning board thing, but there are a lot of demographic studies that indicate that we're in a declining region.
That's interesting. I've heard that before. We're just talking about what the possibilities of what we heard at the public hearing about buying land, larger land, so you could have the three complexes together and stuff. To me, and I think everyone agreed that it just is going to make the project so large it will never pass. You know, and the important part of it is getting the police out of the cellar, most important. So I think that's what we need to concentrate on. I mean, we heard them, but just we're talking 3 million plus. HS won't go. I can't see that, you know. Even if you just did the construction of the town and police on land you have to buy, and maybe fire years later, I mean, you still have to buy that, possibly buy that land. I don't know what the options are right now, but I don't know.
I think it's probably more helpful for them to continue to meet.
Oh, the meetings, of course. But, yeah. Of course.
Yeah, and I think once you hear, and we know, as you said, one way or the other, that gives us
direction as to what we really need to do at that point.
Of course, because I think we don't know what the possibilities are with the land, and it could possibly be a good thing, but you don't necessarily have to build all three of them at the same time,
correct,
just as long as there's room to grow. And I think that's what people were saying. They wanted the ability to grow if it needed to, where they felt that Silver Street wasn't going to do anything but what it's going to be on, what we were first proposing.
I mean, it's probably not likely or possible that selling the Silver Street lot, selling this building, might make it at zero that disappointment, right?
Probably not.
That bad?
Well, no. You know, the developers take over a 4 years ruling. They don't pay market price. Mm-hmm. They give the town a stipend. Mm-hmm. And then they spend the millions of dollars to refurbish it to get it back from the tax.
And then the tax is help fund it.
Yeah.
So
to say.
It's not
like
a one
dollar
really, is it?
I don't know. Without talking to them, I don't know. But
I hope not. But selling the land would go towards
that
if we sold silver.
That could be used for that.
Yeah. But so what do you think, Charlie?
This is all beyond my realm of expertise.
OK. But I'm just thinking, the three projects together, or just sticking with police and county administration?
Well, beyond my realm of expertise, because I think politically, it's all a challenge. It's a challenge because as you get into public hearing process, I think that there are groups of people who will say, pardon my French, why the hell didn't you be more foresighted and plan to do the whole job at once? This, you know, this is short-sighted. And I think if you do go forward with a, you know, multi-unit development, there'll be people who will pound the table just as hard and say, why, you know, this is too big, why are you doing this? So, and I don't have any insight. I mean, I've shared with the committee and with Bob before. The people I talk to are the historical people who would be, you know, hurt. And, you know, I smile politely when people say, you know, tear this place down. But people that I hear are not saying this is. You know, as you think about the fabric of a small New England town, this is a part of that fabric. And if you say, I don't care about this fabric, you're sending a very interesting message to people who do care about the fabric. So,
so my question is, what are they proposing to do with this building?
I mean, I think their plan would be, you know, put some more money into it and make it better. I'm not here to defend that.
But they promised 20 years ago that they would do that, that they would take care of the third floor. That's why one of the reasons why we stayed. And, you know, the other projects came available, and they jumped on that. And, you know, nothing has been done to the third floor. And unfortunately, during the renovation of the rest of this floor and the bottom floor, you know, they cut. So, you know, you're probably going to spend as much or even more just to renovate the same existing space and still not have the additional room that we need and that the town needs.
Right.
You know, without taking that building or taking that building and then, you know, then you've got an albatross because you have a historical building with some type of an annex hanging off one end of it that doesn't fit the fabric of the original building.
And how does the Historical Society come and play with that?
No, I'm sorry, not the Historical Society.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, people who care about the historical.
No, but we're under the.
Are we on the National Register?
Aren't we? So I don't know if there's restrictions to do anything to add on or do any of those kinds of things. I don't know anything that we would have to talk to whoever knows that, either an issue or whoever it is. So I don't know if you can do that.
But if we've had a hearing and, you know, if the input from the community was what, then I apologize for missing it. Do all three together? Is that what we are?
Well, I think that there was several, not all of them were, but there were several that said that Silver Street doesn't have a place for growth. That's pretty much what they were saying. If our town grows and grows, what will happen with the police station? Because you don't have anywhere to go, and town administration as well. So, because we're looking at other options for the town administration too, either, you know.
But I think Kim's point is good. We do get to the point and grow, then yeah, move town administration somewhere else, move the cops to the upstairs part of the building as an expansion, and then we do town administration, maybe we do town administration and a fire station.
And library.
All, you know, together, but this buys us.
Well, what's wrong with the fire station? I don't understand this need to.
I don't think we need
the fire station.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think we do need a fire station. That's my opinion, and talk to Harry as well. I mean, they need modifications, absolutely need upgrading. That it is old inside, their bathrooms or kitchens. It would be great if they could have an upstairs training room, you know, and possibility of having living quarters if it eventually got to that point where they needed to have some coverage day and night. But the station itself is sound, and there's no leaks. It just needs to be modified.
And I guess what I fear is if we can do that, great, but if we can't, again, I would hate to nickel and dime an old building, band-aid it together, because we see what happens.
Yeah.
You can't keep doing that.
Yeah.
You end up spending more money in the long run, rather than bite the bullet and say, okay, you know, let's cover losses, which is what I feel we need to do with this building, because it's just gonna, it's death by a thousand cuts. It's gonna keep bleeding the town. And we gotta get you guys out of the basement. I mean, I shouldn't tell you this, but in my travels, I've been to some places up in Vermont, my God, Bobby's just gorgeous. You know, and the chiefs tell me that, you know, their folks are, you know, their recruitment's up because people say, yeah, that I work here, and this is a beautiful building, it's gorgeous. And I think that will, you know, it's good for morale, and we've gotta get you out of the basement. So to me, that's the primary thing, get the police out of the basement. And then this building, if you know, we can put the town hall on top of it, that's the way I think we have town. And leave fire down the road. And that still puts us at two.
Yeah, it was.
Well, it'd be a hair or two.
Yeah.
You know, you're talking, you know, when you figure contingencies, because, you know, you always find something that they have. When I sent out the financial thing, I had 1.5 for the police. That was more than enough contingency equipment, everything. So I think if you're talking another 8 to 9 for the second floor, you're probably 2.3.
Yeah.
It wasn't double the cost.
And one of them, thank you for your notes, they were awesome. One of the ones, second presentation did not contain parking lot, was it? Is that right?
They did. They both contained parking lot.
What did it not contain? Generator.
It was a generator. Oh, landscaping.
Landscaping.
Neither one contains a generator, okay.
I think they have basic landscaping and all the type of those.
I think that might have been it, yeah.
Do we have a generator?
This building, yes.
Oh, so we would take that over there?
No, that one's too old.
This one is ready to go.
Okay. But you're playing for a new building.
Would include a generator, yes.
And there's discussion about federal grant money.
Yeah, I was gonna say grants or something, right?
Security. Yeah, I've already talked to Phones Homeland Security that there's money for a generator and there's money to get like smart boards, large screen TVs, tables, chairs, podiums for the emergency operations room.
Awesome.
So,
which also could double as a public.
Which would double as a public
conference.
Conference room, yeah. Police training.
Awesome. That's great. Yeah. So, what do we want to wait and hear what Dr. Bob has a couple of meetings so he's got planned?
I think we need to finalize the cover recommendations.
Yeah, because we're running out of very tight schedule now with SB2, it makes it a little even tighter. So we need to make a decision after what we find out from. Now, what did you guys think about between the two, I'm sorry, yeah, no, you went there, but between the two proposals, did you have a preference on which one you liked the best?
I like Frozen.
That's the second one, right?
Yeah.
Yep, me too. Mostly because of the efficiencies that it has for utilities and stuff. I mean, I just think that as time goes on, it was save us a ton of money.
And the durability of the building itself.
And the durability, yeah.
So the cement walls would stand there longer than wood frame wall.
Yeah. Charlie, what did you think?
I also prefer Groen, although, again, I don't mean to be the naysayer here, but this is a town that doesn't maintain stuff, doesn't want to put money into maintaining stuff. And I don't see why arguing for durability is a sale for it. In other words, the politics of it, I think, are you're sort of throwing salt in the wound. If you build up durability, you're throwing salt in the wound of people who say, well, this was built to be durable. You didn't care to maintain this, so why should we make, why is that a selling point for the new one?
I think that was history, Charlie. I think the Republican administration is different today.
No.
We have capital planning. We have capital planning now.
It's not different because we don't want to maintain this, and I understand. Again, I'm just saying it's a political consideration. I don't know if the historical people or even a quarter of the voters, so you may not have to worry about them. But I would, my caution about growing is I wouldn't play up durability, I would play up some utility savings or something else. But, you know, to me, that just, I'm like, there's so many people who are saying, torch this building, well, then you don't want a building that's gonna last 100 years, because nobody's gonna maintain it. Nobody wants to put a dime in.
Well, I think that has to be part of the plan for the future, as well, in the future. Because we've seen it, you know, with the fire department, when they put that albatross and an addition on, you know, it's, they didn't do it correctly. They said, here's the amount of money that you have, just do what you can with it. Let's do it right, I'll give you a couple extra $1,000, so it looks like it's one continuous building. But so, you know, if the town does decide to do something with it, police or place a town hall or whatever, you know, the mindset has to be that, right, we need to add something to the budget. You don't have to do it right away, because everything is under the warranty for at least, you know, 1 to 3 years, depending on what the product is. But at some point, you need to set aside line items that are, right, $5,000, $10,000 for maintenance issues. Make sure it gets painted every couple of years, the woodwork gets painted every couple of years. Now make sure the gutters get cleaned out, or whatever it is.
Carpeting everything.
Or you have yearly maintenance on your generators and your ACs. How many years has it been that we haven't done that?
The other thing I like about the ICS, or whatever they call it, is, you know, in terms of durability, it doesn't need a whole lot of maintenance, because it's concrete. That appeals to me. The other thing I like is the security aspect. You can't shoot through it. And in this day and age of where what we go through, I mean, you have a small police department, it's not in the middle of anywhere, and, you know, I think it's a security issue too to have that. You know, so somebody can't drive by and, you know, shoot up the place and hurt people who are going to be inside, because you can't shoot through those walls.
You still have to worry about the windows, but...
Yeah, the windows, yeah.
But even still, I don't know if you plan for... I think Farmington did downstairs. They have...
They did the front of the building with where the secretaries were. Yeah. And the two windows that are go trick with the control, I guess.
And did you plan that too? Yeah. Was it more money?
Well, it's a lot of money.
It is a lot of money.
I'll just be happy to have the basement.
Yeah.
You can always, you know, things like that can always be added at a
later point.
It's interior cosmetic.
Yeah.
Even though it's a safety issue, it's really cosmetic interior, so.
But still, keeping, even though the building is not needing as much updating, the stuff within the building does, and that's what we have to stay on.
The HVAC system, the heating, all
of those have to be
on maintenance
program.
Exactly. And, you know, somebody's got to
cleaning furnaces and all of that stuff, which doesn't happen unless it goes down.
And we talked about the, you know, the person over at the school, the facilities manager. If we expand that to school and municipal buildings, so we have somebody that's looking after these things and saying, okay, well, we installed this thing 5 years ago, it needs X, Y, and Z. Let's change the oil and, you know, do that sort of stuff. I think for somebody to keep after that is good. You know, for the building, that shouldn't be good, because you have your own stuff to do with the police department. You shouldn't be the maintenance guy running around with a wrench, too. So, which you probably are now.
Well, originally, we did have a plan for all this, like, but back in the day, you know, they didn't want to spend money for preventative maintenance.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't, you know, until like the last 7 or 8 years that the board finds, all right, you know, we need to have a service contract for the furnace so it gets cleaned out every day. We need to have the folk come in yearly and clean out the ductwork so we don't have to mold the mildew and the ducts and things like that. So, you know, I'll give the last couple of boards credit that they've finally seen the light, that they need to look in the future. So, and hopefully, you know, it'll maintain.
And I think we save money in the long run by doing it, you know, by extending the life of the stuff we have, and, you know, I think it's better rather than just saying that we'll wait till it breaks.
Yeah.
Which I think we've done.
It's a complicated political dynamic in the town about taxes, so we take a lot of pride that we have the lowest tax rate in the county, and that's been a point of pride, I think, since I moved here. That penny wise sometimes is pound foolish, but you know, fights we have over the school budget.
Mm-hmm.
Think of the pressure on the municipal side to hold, to kind of hold the line so that it didn't look like the municipal budgets were ballooning the way that they were to the parts of the state. Those are, you know, in powerful dynamics that we, you know, I'm not here to, I don't think those dynamics are directly relevant to whatever recommendation we're going to make. We're going to make the recommendation that we think is best for the town.
Well, I think to some extent they are, because that's what's got us in the situation we're in. By not funding this stuff over the years and, you know, the roads and everything else has put us in this position of having all of a sudden, you know, the sky is falling. And so, that's my
And when you start dealing with something that has been maintained for 20 years, start digging it up and then you find things that you, you know, what's underneath and, so. Yeah. Yeah.
I found all sorts of stuff in the walls of my house over there. My house is like 100 years old.
Yeah.
But I haven't found like the gold pieces.
Yeah, there's some of the money stuff in the walls. okay, so kind of where we go from here?
Do you want to schedule it to you?
I need to find out when Bob is going to have his meetings.
Yeah.
So as soon as he.
I have not heard from the boys as of yet, so
okay.
Once I do. I told them, so I think it's done within a week if possible.
Yeah.
But once I have that meeting, I'll send out an email.
Okay.
You know, it's been done. And
yep. And
what the
we
thoughts
can,
were.
And then we can be in kind of like, all right, this is what we're going to do going
yeah.
forward. So what nights of the week are the best for people? Wednesdays or Thursdays, you know? Wednesdays or Thursdays, okay. Charlie? Just depends on the day.
Wednesday is a little better for
okay.
me, although 6:30 is a hard start time because I finish teaching at 5.
Do you want it like 7?
7 would be better.
7's okay with me. Is that okay with you guys? Okay.
Thursdays probably work. I'm splitting that course with other folks. They're likely to carry most of the work on their hands.
Okay, so we'll be for Wednesdays at 7. And Wanda, they haven't set a budget committee schedule of meetings, have they?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, there is a meeting schedule.
Mm-hmm. Could you forward that to me?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Or Nancy, one of these?
October 24th.
It's an email.
Is the next
one?
Is
the next
one. Oh,
October
24th. Oh, yeah.
It's the next budget
Yeah, because I
still want to.
I believe by October everything they're supposed to have everything into to the town
yeah.
by then.
So do we have an update on the bond rates? The program will have that as well.
I'm gonna reach out to them and ask them to update that last information.
And you strictly went through banks, right?
Not went to the bond bank.
Mm-hmm.
The
right.
municipal bond bank.
Oh, the municipal bond
yeah.
bank, okay. Because Suzanne was saying that, was it USDA? Was it there?
Yeah.
And so we should try to stay away from that one. So either banks or the municipal land bank would be our desire. Just they have a lot of paperwork for the USDA one.
There's some folks sending questions. Suzanne that was going to get answers about people are going to want to know about what kind of work has to go into this building because you know, it's going to come up in a public hearing. I thought we had a list of things that we were going to be prepared to talk about if we came up with a public hearing. Is that Suzanne?
Well, she's gone now, you know that, right?
It
was in one, yeah.
Yeah.
I know I gave you a preliminary one. I think the select board some time ago, the top HVAC, the one generator,
yeah.
Just
mm-hmm.
to start with.
Yeah.
It came up in the public hearing that you gave a partial list.
Yeah.
Help me to understand what it is that we're recommending. Are we recommending a land deal, possibly recommending a land deal plus a building?
Okay.
Well,
because if you haven't talked with somebody, that's nice, but that's not a purchase and sale agreement or anything.
He missed the first part.
I did, yeah.
Yeah, you can explain what you might be, as much as you can share.
I'm meeting with a family in town that owns a large parcel of land. That would be an ideal spot for a municipal complex. And the patriarch of the family is very receptive to doing something. But because he's quite elderly, he wants his two adult children to be involved in his initial talks anyway. And that's why I'm waiting to set up a meeting there. Whether it's a purchase or a land swap or a right donation to the town, possibly, I don't know. But hopefully something. So in the event that you start out with just one or two items on this property, it does give you the future growth if the town ever decides to make it bigger. Okay. So
just thinking from the standpoint of putting together warrant articles and so forth, that gets very hard very fast. So in other words, a warrant article to propose building a police station on the Silver Street lot, I can think of how you word that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I can't think of how, it doesn't mean it can't be worded, but I can.
You probably have to have several points, one for the authorization of mm-hmm. purchase or receiving or mm-hmm. land swap or this mm-hmm. or whatever it is, and then one for the building.
Right, we'd have to get some legal opinion on that for sure.
Sure.
Like what they're sitting right now, or I'm sure not at all aware of what that would be. So
I think that the committee was kind of of the mindset that unless it's a smoking deal, we felt the Silver Street property was still very deal right for the police and town.
Yeah, because I mean, we just felt that one, you don't have to pay for it, so it just ups the price, by if we had to buy versus whatever it was going to be. So I think that it depends what this conference, this talk is going to be, and then you have to come to the board of selectmen anyway.
Of course. Yeah.
And then we can then decide exactly. And if people are out there that's saying that we just absolutely don't think that Silver Street is big enough, they'll vote it down. I mean, that's the bottom line. But I think that, if that's what the only option is at this point. I'd rather have town. I can't see what we can have 5 acres of land just and be where you want to be within the village the main part of town. You don't want to be on the outskirts, way out in the woods and whatever, So I think that it limits you.
I think you're more likely going to have opposition on costs than you are growth.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. But I think $2.5 million, knowing that they don't have to maintain this building, is probably, I think that it's going to be acceptable. I mean, if it's going to happen at all, that would be probably their price point.
Yeah.
Anything over that?
Anything over that, we're going to be. It's just, I don't think it's going to pass either, and having the multi-complexes and buying land and having to buy land, I just,
so how are we doing?
All right, so we will wait and see what you find out, and then I will set a meeting up to come back and discuss it with what we're going to bring forward, okay?
The 5th is bad for me.
The 5th of?
Of September.
Oh, no, that's
right after.
Maybe day.
Maybe after later.
I don't think it
might
be
before that.
And the 12th doesn't work for me because we've got CPA that night.
Okay, yeah, I'm going to try not to have it at any night that someone else has it, which is kind of hard, but yeah. And those are both September's, right? Okay, sounds good. So we'll just wait and see. Good luck.
Well, thank you.
Thanks for all your work.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you for